Fire is a part of life in Australia. And for millions of years, the landscape and all of us who share it, the plants, the animals, and in more recent years, the humans, have had to learn ways to evolve, to respond and adapt. Nature Conservation Council of New South Wales has an initiative called the Hotspots Fire Project. This innovative project is bringing rural communities together to look at how they can actively manage fire on the land, not only to protect people's lives and property, but also to protect the landscape and the incredible variety of plants, insects, birds and other animals that are a part of it.
The Australian bush has evolved with variable fire regimes over millions of years. Even before there were people on this continent, there used to be lightning strikes and there would have been fires. And so plants and animals often have ways to deal with a fair amount of variability in fire regimes. What you don't want is the real extremes. You don't want things being burnt as soon as they're able to be burnt or being left for ages and ages. There are interconnections in nature, and when you alter one bit of it, it can throw other things out of balance that you've never even thought about. So if you lose a suite of plants and animals because you have taken fire regimes way out of where they have been, then all sorts of things may happen as a result of that.
I didn't really even understand what biodiversity meant. It's a word that's thrown around a lot. But, you know, it's no good just having, you know, one species of tree or one species of animal. You need everything to work together to keep the landscape healthy, which of course keeps us healthy, which of course keeps our children healthy.
Hotspots is really critical at the moment. And it's really focused at the moment because of, I think, climate change. You know, what the scientists are telling us, what government's telling us, it's a reality. And we need to plan for that. If it's going to be hotter and drier, then we need to prepare for that. It's going to have an impact on what we grow and the way we manage our farms and the way we treat fire. Are we going to have more fire regimes? Is it going to be more? Are we going to be more prone to fire attack?
Across New South Wales, the Hotspots Fire Project has been bringing together a diverse range of people. Landowners, firefighters, rangers, land care, forestry and national parks people. In fact, whole rural communities are coming along to these workshops.
How could a private landowner possibly be across 27 different pieces of legislation? So they put together...
The environment is one. This farm is a part of the environment as that farm is a part of the environment, as that national park, as that state forest. It's all one. And one of the issues that we've had is everyone was treating every bit as an individual portion instead of holistically. As much as I hate the word holistic, it's an appropriate word. And if we can get planning on private property and national park and forest that all fits together and dovetails, the outcomes have to be really, really good.
Land management zones, strategic fire management zones, and asset protection zones.
Now they all. The basic message that we're trying to get across, I think, is that fire is a really important part of the Australian bush in many, many places, and that therefore, if you want to conserve your native plants and animals, you need to think very carefully about your fire management. Another message is that both too frequent fire and too infrequent fire can have a negative impact on plants and animals. So we're aiming for the middle ground, and what that middle ground will be is dependent on the sort of bush that you're dealing with, what kind of vegetation type that you're working in.
What we're trying to do is we've got people with different kinds of knowledge. We've obviously looking at our heritage, our Aboriginal cultural heritage, and people who have been fire stick farming for thousands and thousands of years. There's also landholders who've been there for several generations who've got a lot of practical knowledge about fire and have been running fire through their country. But we've also got people who are sitting in the sort of more traditional science of our universities who've been doing a lot of experiment-based work in looking at fire and habitat and how fire and habitat are related. So what we need to do is bring all those types of knowledge together so that everybody's got the whole picture, not just part of it.